सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकन्नामरूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं हः तदेवाहन्नमस्तोऽन्यद्दिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So last we saw that एवं अशेष दुःख निदानं स्वस्वरूप अज्ञानं इति सिद्धम्। In this series, Sadhu has analyzed that how a Viveki understands through stages as to without Ajnana going, there cannot be Ashesha Dukkha Nivritti, because Ajnana will always let the Vasanas manifest as Ragadvesha, Ishtanishta, Ragadvesha, and then Karma, Phala, thereby Dukkha Rupa Samsara, because Sharira will be born as Phala. Elsewhere in Karika and in 13th chapter of Gita, 13th chapter of the Gita, and Bhashya in that sense, there is also word Hetu and Phala used for the same reason, that Hetu Phala we understand as cause and effect, but it is also the Karma and the Phala, Karma Phala, meaning the body and the next body. The current body and the next body is also called as Hetu Phala. Current body becomes a cause, karma being done in the current body becomes a cause for another body. That body is a phala, which will again become a hetu for another phala. So it is cause and effect, where the effect is also the cause. The series continues. So Ankura Bija Nyaya, it will never stop unless Ajnana, the root cause, is taken away. Thereby, the next point Sadhu makes is ततः स्वस्वरूप अज्ञानं स्वस्वरूप ज्ञानेनैव निवर्तते न अन्येन। हाउ कैन दिस अज्ञान गो नाउ? अज्ञान इज नॉट अभाव, अदरवाइज यू कैन नॉट हैव अ फ्रेज आल्सो व्हिच इज वैलिड इन ग्रामर सेइंग और इवन मेक सेंस दैट अज्ञान कैन गो। इफ अज्ञान इज अभाव रूप, हाउ कैन इट गो? इट इज नेवर देयर। ऑल यू नीड टू डू इज डू नथिंग। You don't have to do anything if Ajnana is Abhava Rupa, because Abhava cannot be the cause for anything. Otherwise, we will become Shunyavadi. Those who say Ajnana is Abhava Rupa, Abhavarthe Nyan, somehow they miss that this is Shunyavada. It may not be Shunyavada, but it cannot. The person who argues that Ajnana is Abhava Rupa and still I am a Samsari due to that has no argument with a Shunyavadi. In Sampradaya proper, Abhava, Ajnana there is Nanj, Nanj Tatpurusha, and Nanj Tatpurusha there, Nanj is in the sense of Virodha, Virodharthe Nanj. Therefore, Ajnana, as long as it is strong, we need not say it is bhava rupa. For us, it is mithya, mithya bhava rupa, in the sense it is not sat, but vyavaharika sat we have to accept, vyavaharika satta, because karyanumeya, maya, avidya, maya, same thing, karyanumeya. You see the effect, you have to infer the cause. There cannot be a causeless effect. Whatever is the satta of the effect, Karana can also be considered as having the same satta in this case. So, व्यावहारिक सत्ता यू सी फॉर प्रपंच यू सी संसार यू सी युअर सेल्फ एज अ संसारी यू कैनॉट डिनाय व्यावहारिक सत्ता टू अज्ञात सो इट इज यत्किंचित भाव रूप यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट यत्किंचित एटलीस्ट सम काइंड ऑफ भाव पदार्थ इज देयर विच अपोजिस ज्ञानोत्पत्ति इफ ज्ञानोत्पत्ति ज्ञान इज स्ट्रॉन्गर That is why even after jnana, if the viparita bhavana is there, samshaya and viparita bhavanas are there, then jnana will not be strong enough to counter ajnana, which has not gone completely. So it is always whichever is stronger will win. So ajnana can go away only by a stronger jnana. So here the ajnana is related to swaswarupam. In the case of Rajju Sarpa, Rajju Swarupa Ajnana, how will it go? Rajju Swarupa Ajnana, in that case, there is Tula Ajnana, Tula Vidya. Regarding Rajju, there is Ajnana. What does that mean? Whatever is similar to Rajju can be the projection now. There can be Vikshepa related to anything which is similar to Rajju. And how will it go? It will go only by Rajju Swarupa Jnana. Yatharta Jnana. Swarupa Jnana is Yatharta Jnana. Yatha Bhavati Tatha. The way the Rajju is, the Vastu is, in that manner if one understands the Vastu, the Rajju, then the Sarpa Ajnana, Sarpa Bhranti will go because of Rajju Jnana. Similarly here, Tataha Swaswarupa Ajnanam, स्वस्वरूप ज्ञानेनैव निवर्तते नान्येन नो अदर प्रोसेस अदर देन ज्ञाना डेफिनेटली नथिंग विल टेक इट अवे आल्सो ज्ञाना विच इज नॉट रिलेटेड टू स्वस्वरूप विल नॉट टेक इट अवे इफ पर्सन स्टडीज पुराण इतिहास एज स्टोरीज और एज फैक्ट्स आल्सो फाइन बट इफ वन मिसेस द मॉरल ऑफ द स्टोरी देयर द मॉरल इज आल्सो स्वस्वरूप ज्ञान देयर All these shastras are also focused towards the same story. Vaya dharma, kramena, but in the end, Bhishma Pitama or someone, somewhere else someone will be giving jnana. That is the focus area. That will give moksha. If one keeps on talking about glories, Bhagavatam, if one misses the aikya there and thinks that, oh, what leela, then one has missed the point. Even in Bhagavatam, let's say there is Leela, Krishna Leela, dancing with so many Gopikas. What is the idea there? One Krishna dancing with so many Gopikas. Gopikas are Jivas. One Krishna is the consciousness there, Brahma, who has never changed. The same Krishna appears as Krishna, my Krishna, to each and every Gopika. My Krishna. This is my Atma, we say. Where is that my Atma? Abhede Tatparyaha. So, even there, if one understands that one Krishna, the same Krishna, in the form of Krishna, really cannot be segmented as individuals with each and every Gopika, it is driving home the point that with each Jiva, Jivatva Bhava where there is segmentation, that is the Leela, that is the Maya Shakti, Vikshepa, otherwise it is the same Krishna who has never segmented. Taijasavat, like in Swapna, there is lot of segmentation without actually being segmented. There is Swarupa Jnana, which is being taught using examples so that one can understand easily. If one holds on to only that, then that will not take away Ajnana. Anyena na nivartate. Tayoho tamah prakashavat paraspara virodhitvat iti viveka utpadyate. For the sadhaka, viveki, the next stage of viveka is Tamah prakasha vat ajnana and jnana are so opposite to each other that tamah prakasha vat paraspara virodha, mutually opposed to each other. Wherever there is darkness and pitch dark, there a little light won't do. People think that okay, tamaha is abhava of light. Science says that. Science says that darkness is absence of light. Is it really so? As per Shastra, not true. Why? Because ghana tamaha, if there is ghana tamaha, if there is pitch darkness, then a little light, should it, does it take it away? Why is the quantity of light, intensity of light needed equivalent to the kind of tamas? Little light does not take it away. You need the light sufficient enough to take away the darkness in the entire area. So the light needed is more. So this is just a logic. We need not analyze it further, just to show that if at all someone has an idea that tamaha means absence of light, it is not so. Need not be so. We need not hold on to science for Shastra understanding. If we use one example which drives home the point, that is sufficient to understand that how ajnana is opposing jnana. So here what happens is that now this sadhaka has viveka, that as long as ajnana is there, I cannot come out of dukkha, and that ajnana will go only by jnana, and whatever is the vishaya of ajnana, same should be the vishaya of jnana. That is the viveka which is born. So one does not spend in all sorts of things attaining jnana regarding anything and everything, but focus is primarily the atma. Yad vishayakam ajnanam bhavati tadajnanam tadvishayaka paroksha jnane neva nivartate yatha rajvajnanam rajju sakshat karene eva nivartate tadvat. So yad vishayakam ajnanam yaha vishaya yasya ajnanasya tadajnanam yad vishayakam. Whatever is the vishaya for ajnana, in this case atma, in the case of rajju, rajju sarpa, rajju. Rajju is the vishaya. So rajju vishayakam ajnanam rajju jnanena eva nivartate. It will go only by rajju jnana, because the ajnana is related to rajju. So rajju vishayakam ajnanam rajju vishayaka aparoksha jnanena eva nivartate. In this case, in the exemplified atma, brahmatma, so ajnana is related to atma, therefore it will go by atma jnana alone. So pratyaksha, here rajju sakshatkara is there. Rajju pratyaksha, the way he has sarpa pratyaksha, similarly rajju should become pratyaksha. Only then the it will go there. In the case of pratyaksha, there pratyaksha bhranti is also possible. Pratyaksha bhranti, it is not prama. Rajju is aprama. Sarpa is aprama, rajju is prama. So rajju prama will take away sarpa brahma. Both are pratyaksha. One who is seeing sarpa, to him it is pratyaksha, but the earlier pratyaksha is bhranti rupa, brahma rupa, sarpa. Why? Because it will go away, it will get badha in the same time frame. In the example, in the vyavaharika dasha itself, it will go away by rajju jnana. Therefore, there is badha possible. Thereby, it is brahma, not prama. So, rajju jnana, though rajju pratyaksha, is prama rupa. It will not go away in vyavaharika dasha. In the exemplified, ajnana regarding atma will go away when the jnana regarding atma is stronger enough to counter the ajnana. Tasmat swaswarupa aparoksha jnanam eva akhila anartha nidana swaswarupa jnana nivritti dvara nishreyasa atmaka nikhila dukkha nivritti hetur bhavati. Thereby it is proven now that swaswarupa aparoksha jnanam, only aparoksha jnana relating to one's own swarupa. Aparoksha jnana, otherwise called as anubhava or anubhuti. Same meaning. This aparoksha jnana, which is in the case of the example, it is objectifiable. The vishaya is objectifiable. In the case of exemplified, in the case of example, it is objectifiable rajju. In the case of exemplified, swaswarupa is not objectifiable. Therefore, if one thinks that this anubhava is sakshatkara, is of the sort of same experience, it will not be. There it is objectifiable experience. Here it is which can never be objectified, a person who keeps on struggling for that kind of a jnana which has a vishaya, which is an object, vishaya is an object, here vishaya is subject matter, not subject or subject matter, whereas vishaya in the case of example is the object, there the anubhava is objectifiable knowledge, an objectified vishaya is the jnana or anubhava. In the case of exemplified, if one wants the same level of experience, same kind, exactly like that, I want only the objectifiable experience, that can be had, but it is not the Atma. It will always be something else. It will always be the with the upadhi, with the antakarana upadhi. Thereby, a person who goes on a trip for an anubhava, objectifiable, will never get it. The journey will never end. Even if he has jnana, it will never end because the ajnana is still there, that I need to objectify it, that which can never be objectified. The very content of the objectifier can never be objectified. It is a waste to even try it. Therefore, that yatkinchit ajnana will keep the person in samsara. What is the real anubhava here? Anubhava is without the sadhana, without any indriya. It is not indriya gochara, it is not mana gochara. With the manaha, you get the vritti, all right. Buddhi vritti is necessary. But that buddhi vritti will take away ajnana. After that, if the craving for anubhava or jnana, either, because both are same. I am not saying anubhava is different and one should not hanker after anubhava, one should hanker after jnana. Jnana is also same thing. Jnana also is a sakarmaka dhatu. In fact, anubhava, the reason it is preferable is because bhu is an akarmaka dhatu. However, as soon as you add anu, it will become sakarmaka. Because anu paschat, following what? If you say following what, anu is in the meaning of paschat, then following what? There has to be an object. If that is how the understanding is, it is, the understanding is also incorrect. Anubhava will also be a trip. Search for anubhava. So it is when that ajnana goes away, there is no doubt that I am of that swarupa. I can never be experienced. I can never be an object of knowledge even. So that jnana also, aparoksha jnana, should culminate in chaitanya, which has no vishaya, it has no karma, it is not sakarmaka, it is akarmaka, it has nothing other than itself. There is no pramana for another chetana. All pramanas are bhranti there, they are not pramanas. There is all brahma that there is division in chaitanya, because all our so-called pramanas for chaitanya being segmented are other sentient beings. We say something out there. What is out there? Body is out there. Say in here also, what do I see? There is a body. Between the body there is bheda, but is there a bheda in Chaitanya? There is no pramana. I may not be able to prove it that Chaitanya is one. Shruti alone is the pramana. But if you want logical pramana, you have to establish. The onus is on the Purva Pakshi to establish that there is another Chaitanya, which cannot be established no matter what. If he says that, I feel so, feeling is not a pramana. If you see someone outside, seeing is not a pramana, because you are seeing the body, you are not seeing Chaitanya. If you say I infer it, inference is based on what? Inference is based on some kind of a spurana. You see spurana due to prana in something and you say therefore I infer Chaitanya. Or kriya is there, therefore it is chetana. That inference is not valid because it doesn't say another chetana. It all say, all it may point out to is, first of all, it has a dependency on pratyaksha. Second, even if you agree with it that, okay, let's agree with the inference that there is chetana which you can infer, still that chetana is seen due to upadhi, so it has to be rejected. Bheda cannot be proven even if you prove that it is Chetana. Thereby, Swaswarupa Aparoksha Jnanam is this Aikya Jnana, विच विल टेक अवे अखिल अनर्थ निदान विच इज अज्ञान कारण एंड दैट इज वॉट दैट इज स्वस्वरूप अज्ञान देर फोर स्वस्वरूप अपरोक्ष ज्ञानम एव अखिल अनर्थ अनर्थ निदान स्वस्वरूप अज्ञान निवृत्ति द्वारा टेकिंग दैट अवे अज्ञान रिगार्डिंग वन सोन स्वरूप विच इज एकमेवाद्वितीय What happens is that it because through that nishreyasa atmaka nikhila dukkha nivritti hetu bhavati hetur bhavati. It becomes the cause to take away the entire dukkha, which is what this swarupa. What is the swarupa of nikhila dukkha nivritti? Nikhila dukkha nivritti cannot be in any other so-called states except what. निश्रेयस सो निश्रेयस इज आत्मा आत्मा स्वरूपम निश्रेयस आत्मक निखिल दुख सो निखिल दुख निखिल दुख निवृत्ति सो निखिल दुख निवृत्ति इज निश्रेयस आत्मक निश्रेयस इज मोक्ष मोक्ष आत्मक दैट अज्ञान निवृत्ति वाया ज्ञान बिकम्स द कॉज फॉर निवृत्ति ऑफ एंटायर दुख Which itself is called as moksha. Nishresa atmaka is equal to nikhila dukkha nivritti. And hetu is what? Ajnana nivritti. For which the hetu is swaswarupa aparoksha jnanam. Eva. Eva kara is there. Not anything else. Swaswarupa seva satya jnana ananta ananda brahmarupatva. Swaswarupa seva. Now Shruti says what is this swarupa of one's own you should say one's own swarupa, not one's own atma, but what is the atma swarupa? Atma is pratyagatma. For each one, atma means myself, reflexive. And then, if you remove the kosha sambandha, then you know that it is your own swarupa, which is without any upadhi, without any tadatma sambandha with any kosha, without even the antakarna, which makes jnana and anubhava possible. Without any of these, what am I really? Satya Jnanananta Brahma Rupa. That is what I am. And Tasmat Swaswarupa Jnanena Brahma Vaptir Bhavati. So this Nikhila Dukkha Nivritti is Brahma Vaptihi. Prapti. ब्रह्मचर नित्य निरतिशय अखंडानंद रूपम दुखा संभिन्नम इति सर्व वेदांत प्रमाण सिद्धम तो सर्व वेदांत प्रमाण सिद्धम एवरी उपनिषद इज कमिटेड टू दिस वेरी रिवीलिंग दिस वेरी तत्व विच इज ब्रह्म एंड व्हाट इज दैट ब्रह्म नित्य निरतिशय अखंडानंद रूपम It is not committed to revealing Brahma, but it is committed to revealing Brahma as Atma. That is the accuracy. Brahma, if it is revealing Brahma, then it will be Paroksha. Brahma as Atma is what the Shruti is focused towards. Every Vedanta, even the Prakarana Grantha is also focused towards that. Therefore, Brahma is what? Nitya Niratishaya Akhanda Ananda Rupam. Ananda, which is not having any gradations, priyadi vritti, so priya moda, pramoda, ityadi, these vrittis are not there. The gradations which are discussed in Brahmananda Valli of Taittiriya Upanishad, those are gradations due to upadhi, definitely experienceable with higher upadhi and without the higher upadhi by someone who is a Shrotriya, Shrotriya Siddhi. श्रोत्रियस्य च कामः तस्य श्रोत्रियस्य च अकामः तस्य कामेन न हतस्य यः कामेन न हतः तस्य श्रोत्रियस्य च हि शुड बी अ श्रोत्रिय आल्सो हु इज नॉट अंडर द प्रेशर ऑफ काम विदाउट द हायर उपाधि ही कैन गेट द सेम आनंद इन द सेम उपाधि विदाउट द हायर उपाधि देयर बाय द ग्रेडेशन ऑफ आनंद is not due to upadhi really. It is due to the akamahatattvam. It is due to not being a wanting person. Due to the lack of desire. Why lack of desire does not cover ananda? Swarupa Ananda. So if you extend it to all upadhis, till from the this from this one in the Shruti itself, one who has one unit of Ananda, who is an emperor of this entire prapancha, sadhu person, kyadi, all those descriptions are given. An ideal human being who can never be. Never be, even in Satyuga it is difficult. Imagine an emperor of the entire world who is sadhu, the wealth of the entire world belongs to that person. Ideal case, never possible. But even his ananda is one unit of ananda. And then there are hundredfold gradations in each upadhi reaching to Hiranyagarbha Ananda. All those are gradations. This is without gradations. So Niratishaya Akhanda Ananda Rupam Dukkha Asambhinnam. Asambhinnam here is not even touched. Has no contact possible. Asamsargita Dukkha. Dukkhena Asparshitam. So one does not even have a sparsha of Dukkha. That kind of with Ananda Rupa, because it is one's own Swarupa. All we are trying to do is trying to get seat in Vishaya and trying to attain it so that we experience the reflection of our Ananda. Even to experience it, we have to divide it. And that division will take away its Anantatyam. Because Ananta it will not be. It will be limited, because anything which is experienced means that it is separate. If it is separated, then it will not be Ananta. Swarupa is Ananta, thereby by very definition of Ananta, you cannot have even a little split. You say, let me experience it. I am an Ausha and I want to experience the Aushi Ishvara, who is almost infinite except for me. Even if that kind of an understanding is there, it is mithya. It is not jnana. If one, because you have limited, by being separate, you have limited Ishvara, which is your Swarupa really. You have, and becoming an Ausha itself is, you are minute. So that is okay for bhakti. But it is not jnana. It is not Swarupa jnana. Therefore, mukti is not possible. And this Nitya Niratishaya Akhandananda Rupam Brahma is revealed by Shruti Sarva Vedanta Pramana Siddha, and it is Dukkha Sambhinnam. Untouched by Dukkha. Ata eva Swaswarupa Sakshatkari Naiva Nitya Niratishaya Dukkha Sambhinna Swaswarupa Bhuta Brahmananda Avapyate Prapyate. What is the final source for that Nishesha Dukkha Nivritti and Brahmavapti or Paramananda Rupa Brahmavapti? It is just the attainment of Swarupa Jnana. Evam Nikhila Dukkha Nivritti Upalakshita Swaswarupa Bhuta Khandananda Praptehe Sakshat Sadhanam Swaswarupa Jnanam Eva. Therefore, the Swaswarupa Jnanam is the Sakshat Sadhana for Nikhila Dukkha Nivritti. And Nikhila Dukkha Nivritti is not a separate step. Yesterday I was discussing with someone, so why Paramananda Prapti is mentioned separately in this text? It is not separate. Swaswarupa Bhuta Akhandananda Prapti is what? Is Upalakshita. By, see, Nikhila Dukkha Nivritti Upalakshita. Nikhila Dukkha Nivritya Upalakshitaha Anandaha. Ananda is Upalakshita by it is not separate step. Same thing is Dukkha Nivritti is Paramananda Prapti, because there is no separate step really. If the Dukkha Nivritti has taken place, then the Swarupa Ananda is already Prapta. It is Praptasya Prapti. We have seen Praptasya Prapti Jnanena Bhavati. Therefore, nothing else is remaining to do there. That's why Sakshat Sadhana is Jnana. Jnana cannot give you something positive. Jnana can take away Ajnana, and it can only reveal. It will not give you something positive as a result, such as, you know, in Karma Kanda and Upasana, if they say that, okay, you will get a Siddhi or you have to do something, that is a positive attainment. This is not a positive attainment. It is taking away the misunderstanding, and what you are, that is what you are. Evam Sakshat Sadhavisa Tasma Swaswarupa Vichara Eva Kartavya. Therefore, what has to be done? Swaswarupa Vichara Eva Kartavya. Now, earlier he has said that the Sakshat Sadhana is Mahavakya. Mahavakya, if it has not worked, then Swaswarupa Vichara, meaning Shravana, which is the second part of Shravana. First part of Shravana is Mahavakya Shravana, which will take away the Ajnana. If it does not take away Ajnana there, then the Aparoksha Jnana, it has given Aparoksha Jnana, but it is not strong enough to take away Ajnana Karya, which is Vikshepa, thereby that lingering Vikshepa or the Samshaya which is there, that has to go. So Pramanagata Samshaya will go away by the Swarupa Vichara, which is the second part of Shravana, and then Swarupa Vichara, which is the part of Manana, not part of Manana, entire Manana, which will take away Pramayagata Samshaya, and then Nididhyasana, which will take away the Viparita Bhavana. That alone is Kartavya. Kartavya. Ittham yasya viveko jayate saeva jidnyasu rityuchate. So, jnatum ichyu kaha? Ittham yasya viveko jayate. So, viveka is not just atma anatma viveka, just you know, if you chant that, you know, entire Tattva Bodha by rote, that will not work for us. You know, we have to have this kind of viveka. Ittham yasya viveka jayate saeva jidnyasu. Otherwise, this Jidnyasu stage is missed. One does not become a Jidnyasu, then, and Jidnyasu of this type, if one does not become a Jidnyasu who does not know, rather who, one does not become a Jidnyasu who knows that this is the only means. Aparoksha Jnana, beyond that nothing is needed, that alone is needed. Other Jidnyasus are namesake Jidnyasus, because they will be wanting this as well as something else. That won't work. The apeksha for something else to be done, iti kartavyata, that will take away the jidnyasutvam, tatvika of the jidnyasu, tatvika, it will take away. So, vastuta, he will not remain a jidnyasu. By the yogikartha, he is a jidnyasu, because jnatum ichchu. But Swaswarupa Jnana alone is not wanted by that person. Everything else also is wanted along with the Swaswarupa Jnana. Thereby, he will not be a Kevala Jidnyasu. Kevala Swarupa Jidnyasu he won't be. Thereby, Sa Eva Jidnyasu. Otherwise, others are not Jidnyasu, says Sadhu here. Mukta Lakshana. Now, what is a Mukta Lakshana? Stula Sukshma Karanatmaka Sharira Traya Vilakshanam Pancha Kosha Vilakshanam Cha Swaswarupam Akhandadvitiya Swayam Jyoti Swabhava Ananda Ghana Brahma Rupena Yas Sakshad Aparokshi Karoti Karatala Amalaka Vat Saeva Mukta Ityuchyate. Obviously, the example is of an object, not an objectifiable. People will question, karatala amalaka vat, just like the amalaka, a fruit is there in my hand, that kind of pratyaksha I want to have atma darshanam. Shruti also says, atma vare drashtavya. Drashtavya means, people think that darshana has to be an of an object. Karatala amalaka vat is an example. Okay, what other can be the example? There can be no other example. There cannot be an example. There is no example where the subject knows the subject. If it is an example, then there is no difference between the example and the exemplified, which is not an example. Elsewhere, Bhagavan Bhashyakara gives an explanation as to what is an Udharana. Udharana is comparing an Ekadesha and only the Ekadesha. You should not compare other things. Oh, it is an object. The object is not the comparison here. The comparison is how that pratyakshatvam is there, that I know, Doubtlessly, I know without a doubt, if someone tells you you are holding, you know, you are holding a jackfruit while you are holding an apple, pratyakshatvam is I know, not that object I have in my hand, but I know that it is not a jackfruit, it is an apple. That is the pratyakshatvam compared there. We should not go beyond that example. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara says Udharana is exactly that. With the Ekadesha comparison, the other, the entire is compared. Entire is compared in the exemplified. That part, using a part, the establishment of the whole. In the exemplified, not in the example. So comparison here is Karatala Amalakavak Pratyakshatvam, Aparokshatvam, Sakshad. If you say, oh, have you really seen it yourself? Not as an object. There, Vivaksha is not an object. That you have really seen means I know what I have seen. I know what I have heard. That's why you have really seen versus you have really heard versus you have really tasted. There is no difference because the comparison, although it is of different objects, objectifiable objects, but different. Where once at one place there is Shabda, other place Rasa, third place there is Rupa. Still the Pratyakshatvam is common. Just like I have seen, similarly I have heard. What is the difference? Shabda and Rupa cannot be compared. Do we have an objection there? No. Pratyaksha, I heard it myself. I saw it myself. What is the difference? Pratyakshatvam. There is no, what is common is Pratyakshatvam. Difference is in the object. There we don't compare the objects. We take the Pratyakshatvam as comparable. Similarly here, Pratyakshatvam, I know by myself. You can say Anubhava also there. I have Anubhava of Shabda. I have Anubhava of Sparsha. I have Anubhava of Rupa. That Anubhava is the becomes as though Pramana there for that person because it is Pratyaksha. Pratyaksha is a Pramana. Similarly, this will be Pratyakshavat. Karatala Amalakavat is Pratyaksha Jnanavat. This is Jnana. Sakshat Aparokshi Karoti. Aparoksha Jnana. Yat Parokshavat Tat Aparoksham Karoti Iti Aparokshi Karoti. Chi Pratyanta. What was like Paroksha earlier is made as what I have added. It is not there in the Vritti there. Taddita Vritti does not have that. Yat paroksham tad aparoksham karoti iti aparokshi karoti. What was, but because it was never paroksha, atma which was never paroksha but appeared as paroksha has been made aparoksha by him, by that person. Yaha sahayeva muktaha, that person is muktaha. He does not know the Atma through any Indriya. He does not know the Atma through any means, sadhana, neither antakkarana nor buddhi. He does know the Atma through buddhi, definitely knows it through buddhi, but not as an object. The Brahmakara vritti is without any visheshanas. All the visheshanas drop away. The role of Brahmakara vritti is to take away all namarupa visheshanas, thereby what I remain is aparoksha atma, yat sakshad aparokshad. Brahma is what? Yat sakshad aparokshad, says the Shruti. Which is always sakshad aparoksha. Thereby, karoti is misplaced. Karoti is not really, really karoti. It is karoti iva karoti. If it is said karoti, what is actually, how does he make it aparoksha? What was already aparoksha, by taking away the badakas there, whatever was the obstacle to make it, that has made it paroksha, one takes away those obstacles. That is ajnana and ajnana karya. Therefore, stula sukshma karanatmaka sharira traya vilakshanam. Stula atma has been mentioned here. Atma is what? Swarupa here. That sharira is all stula sharira, sukshma sharira, karana sharira. Looks like Atma, it is not. Vicharam na sahate, that is the ajnana. If you start thinking, then you cannot be the stula sharira, you cannot be sukshma sharira, you cannot be karana sharira. So, traya vilakshana, further panchakosha, am I any of these koshas? No, koshas are karya. I cannot be a karya. I objectify the karya. Panchakosha vilakshana cha swaswarupam. What is that swaswarupam? That is akhandadvitiya swayam jyoti swabhava. Ananda ghana brahma. Tena rupena yaha sakshad aparokshi karati. Tena rupena swaswarupam sakshad karoti. Aparokshi karoti, sakshad karoti, or sakshad aparokshi karoti. What is that swaswarupam? One's own swarupa. Is it different? Yaha and swaswarupa are actually in samana adhikaranyam. Yaha, while doing this sadhana, that time this person is, sadhaka is engaged in the sadhana, he needs these other sadhanas. He is engaged in the pursuit, therefore he needs all the means. He needs the instruments also, the buddhi is needed. But as and when he is using the buddhi and knows that this swaswarupa goes from stula sharira to sukshma, sukshma to karana, and karana to something other than all these three, at the same time or as a different prakriya, he says, I am not annamaya, I am not pranamaya, earlier thought myself as annamaya, but I am not the karya of anna. Without the sharira, the stula sharira or the annamaya kosha, I do exist in swapna. Without the swapna also I exist. So avastatraya vilakshana also, avastatraya abhimani vilakshana also. Panchakosha, annamaya kosha, I am not pranamaya, manomaya, vijnanamaya, anandamaya. Then as and when he is using the buddhi, he has become separate from the vijnanamaya and the buddhi also, cognitively. Then this cognitive separation will land him without a buddhi sambandha also, again cognitively. Then what remains is that buddhi sambandha is dropped and that swaswarupa becomes pratyagatma, which has no pramana to be segmented. So it is akhanda advitiya swayam jyoti swabhava. Swayam jyoti swabhava ananda ghana. It is that ananda which does not have gradations or segmentation, so it is ghana. And that is nothing but Brahma. And tena Brahma rupena yaha swaswarupam sakshad aparokshi karoti saha eva mukta. Example we saw. Further, jijnyasoho asmin granthe pravrutyupapattihi. So he is establishing in conclusion that jijnyasu will have pravrutti in this grantha. Evam purvokta chaturvideshu purusheshu pamara visheinau visheopabhoga janya sukhena eva atmanam truptam krutartam cha manyamanu vartete. Pamara and vishai. Pamara is a dullard, vishaya is a dharmika, but only restricted to the karma kanda and its phala. Therefore, they among the four, evam purvokta videshu. Who are the other two? The other are jijnyasu and mukta. So the earlier two, pamara and vishai, they vishaya upabhoga janya sukhena eva atmanam truptam krutartam manyamano vartete. They consider I am okay with vishaya sukha. They do not know that nitya sukha is swarupa sukha. They consider themselves as happy. So they are not the target for this grantha anyway. Charvakas and karmakandis, if they think that they want swarga, let them have it. What is the problem? We don't have an issue there. If they have an issue that, oh, it is not nitya, then they are the focus. Otherwise, you tell them it is not nitya, that is fine. You tell them it is not nitya, they'll say, I am okay with it not being nitya. There is nothing called as nitya sukha. You can't argue there. Even if they argue, Shruti says it, he says, what nonsense. So you have no argument. There has to be a common ground. There has to be a common ground of agreement. That can be tarka also. These kind of categories, tarka is the only solution. Nothing else is there. Because they don't agree with Shruti as pramana. It would be a waste of time to use Shruti there. In fact, tarka will also be a waste. Bhagavan Bhashyakara has argued this with Buddhist, Jains, as well as, you know, all these who do not have Shraddha in Shruti as pramana. What is the purpose there? so that we do not become like them. It has to protect the sampradayika, vaidikas, astikas. It is not to say that, to convince them. We have refuted them to convince our own people. If they get converted in their erroneous thinking, they are welcome. Otherwise, because with tarka also, it can be shown that you are wrong. But anyway, Pamara cannot understand. He's a dullard. He cannot understand. Vishayi is so much under the influence of Vishaya Sukha, craving, that he is not interested in something which will take time, and he may have to give up Vishaya Sukha. He is not interested to give up Vishaya Sukha now. If you offer him Ananda now, Nityananda, he may be willing to take. But if you say, no, you have to become a Vairagi, he says, I'm not interested. Right now I'm getting Sukha, be it little, but I'm getting it again and again. So he will get stuck there, unless Vichara is backing. So Vishaya Upabhoga Janya Sukheneva Atmanam Tuptam Krutartham Chamanyamano Vartete. Here Atmanam is reflexive. Oneself they consider as Sukhi based on Vishaya or anything else. Vishaya Upabhoga or this, the looking forward for the Sukha elsewhere. So Vishaya is actually also waiting. So he may be easy to convince because Pamara is actually a Laukika Vishayi, whereas this Vishayi is Paramarthika Vishayi of such an order that he wants Swarga Ityadi, Amutra. Amutra Sukha Ichhu there. So Keshanchid Vishayinam Paralaukika Parama Sukhechayam Satyam Api Atat Prapti Sadhanam Meva. Yeah. Paralaukika paramasukechayam satyam api atat prapti sadhanam eva tat prapti sadhanatvena anyatha grihitva tatraiva te pravartante. So although this vishaya is a second category, keshanchit, for some of them, paralaukika paramasukechayam satyam, when they have this kind of a paralaukika sukha ichha, atat prapti sadhanam meva tat prapti sadhanatvena anyatha grihitva. That is not the sadhana for paramananda prapti. They think that atat meaning not that, what is real vastutaha, they don't consider that but something else. So atat prapti sadhanam meva tat prapti sadhanatvena anyatha grihitva. They are mistaken with the sadhana to attain this Parama Sukha, Nitya Sukha. They think that will be Nitya, but their focus is wrong. Their sadhana is misunderstood. They think the what is not sadhana as sadhana. So Tat Prapti Sadhanam is actually Atat Prapti Sadhanam. They consider as Tat Prapti Sadhana. And Tena Anyata Grihitva Tatra Eva Te Pravartante Tasmin Sadhane Eva Pravartante Sadhu Sangha Satchastra Sadhu Sangha Shastra Shravanadi Rupa Paramananda Prapti Sadhana Jnana Bhavat Tesham. Why do they do that? Hetu is given is that Tesham Jnana Bhavat. They do not have Sadhana Jnana. Sadhana Jnana Bhavat. What is a sadhana for Prapti of Paramananda? Which is this sadhana? So this, which is in a sense, this, what is this sadhana? Sadhana is, so sadhana is in samanadikaranam karmadharya with what? Shravanadi rupa. So Shravanadi rupa sadhana is missing. Jnana regarding Shravanadi rupa sadhana is missing. That sadhana is for Paramananda Prapti. So samasa will work that way. Sadhu Sangha Shastra Shravana. Shravana is about, is what Vishayaka? It is Sadhu Sangha Shastra. So Sadhu Sangha and then Shastra Shravana and Sadhu Sangha. Sadhu Sangha is separate, Dvandva. Sadhu Sangha and Shastra Shravana. Adipadena you can add Mananidhyasana Ityadi, Vivekadi or everything there. So Sadhu Sangha is missing, Satsangha is missing and then Shastra they may be looking at some other shastra, karma kanda. That is not sat shastra. Sat shastra is Upanishad. That is how we can interpret it. And that kind of shravana adi rupa sadhana is missing. That sadhana is for paramananda prapti. So paramanandi prapti sadhanam kim? This sadhu sangha sat shastra shravana adi rupam. And with karmadhara after that, sadhana jnana. Sadhana jnana is missing. So what is this jnana regarding that sadhana is missing? And then shashti there, jnanasya abhava tesham. They do not have jnana regarding what is the right sadhana for paramananda prapti, which happens to be sadhu sangha satshastra shravanadi rupa. Thereby what will happen? Dukkha hatyajat na tesham atra granthe pravruttihi bhavati. Upayantare pravuttatvat. Dukkahati. Dukkahati is same as dukkahatya or dukkahananam. So, bhavektin. Bhavektin is added to handhatu. You get dukkahati. Dukkahananam ityartha. So, dukkahatyecha na tesham atra granthe pravruttihi. They won't have pravrutti for destroying dukkha. In this grantha, they won't have it. Upayantare pravruttatva, because they are overloaded with engagements elsewhere. I am too busy to even look at the shastra. That is their idea. Tasmat niratishya sukhavaptaye atyantika dukkhahanayacha pamara vishayinoho asmin granthena sambhavati pravruttihi. Therefore, pamara and vishaya will not have pravrutti in this grantha. For what this grantha, pravrutti should be for what purpose? Prayojana is niratishaya sukha avapti and atyantika dukkha hana, which is same as dukkhati. For that, they don't consider this as a means because they are busy elsewhere. Muktasya api na nasti adhikaraha asmin granthe. And mukta, the fourth category, has no adhikara in this grantha because he already has got this niratishaya sukha and he does not have dukkha, therefore he has atyantika dukkha hana also. Then who is the adhikari or who will have pravrutti in this grantha? The third type, who is a jijnyasu. Jnani hi kritakrutyo mukta iti uchyate. Kritakrutya, we'll see kritakrutya is explained here in tippana, we'll see later. But jnani hi kritakrutyo mukta iti uchyate. Jnani is mukta, therefore he will not have pravrutti. Naiva asti tasya kartavyantaram dhridatara advitiya atma aparoksha, it should be aparoksha, dhridatara advitiya atma aparoksha jnanatvat. Tasya muktasya kartavyantaram nasti, naiva asti. He does not have anything else to do. Why? Dhridatara advitiya atma aparoksha jnanatva. He has aparoksha jnana about this advitiya swarupa of oneself. And it is dhridatara. It is dhrida, not only dhrida, it is dhridatara. He does not slip from that jnana. He stays in that, he has nishtha. Then he may have pravritti, possible, but he has met the prayojana. Even after prayojana, what else is he going to do? He may teach. He may be in some secluded cave like a cave. He may, you know, or he may be, you know, just withdrawn from the society or live in the society as a mudha, unmattavat, elsewhere unmattavat. Or he may continue study for no reason, no particular prayojana per se. Leelayatra kalayapanartham pravrutto api nastyasya granthatah prayojanam. He may do it, may not do it, but he is not the target. So, leelayatra kalayapanartham pravrutto api nastyasya granthatah prayojanam nasti. He may engage pravrutta api, asmin granthe pravrutta api, granthatah prayojanam nasti tasya. He does not have prayojana, but as a leela, or as, you know, just to spend time. Because You have to take carry the time. Time is still there. Prarabdha has the body to survive for that long. How long the jnani also does not know, unless a siddha, he does not care even. But he has to spend time. What will he do? Something he has to do. Anything he do, people may object. Oh, he should not do it. He is a jnani. Whatever he does, people may or may not object. They have their own perspectives. What the jnani should do, he may do anything or may not do anything as per the perspective of the people, onlookers. But if he engages also, granthada prayojan nasti, but still he may engage. But he is not the mukhya target there. But there are people who have pravritti, which is third category. So here, tasman na muktoddeshena api ayam grantha pravrittaha. So sadhu has not created this grantha for time pass of the mukta. They may spend their time, but he is not made it for them. Others are not anyway the target. Who is the target? Jijnyasu. Kintu mumukshurupa jijnyasu muddishya pravrittayam grantha. This is targeted toward the third category of people who are mumukshus, who have become jijnyasus, targeting them. Na tasyasti visheshukecha. He is not like Pamara because he does not, he has vairagya, so visheshuka ichcha is not there. Niratishe bhumananda lipsaya tasya samsara dukkha jihasa vatvat. Niratishe bhumananda lipsaya. He wants this niratishe bhumananda. Alpe sukham nasti. Well, visheshuka is alpa for him. So he gives up the alpa for the bhumananda. Nityananda anantananda. So he wants to have this samsara dukkha jihasa. He has this jihasa vairagya. He does not want samsara dukkha. Kohaktyagi here. So he wants to give up all this samsara, which is dukkha rupa, thereby nitya niratishaya paramananda prapti atyantika dukkha nivruttischa aparokshatma jnanam vina karma yoga sankhya yoga upasanadi bhi na siddhyati iti viveko yasya satsanga jayate tasya jijnyasoho advaita vedanta granthe pravruttir jayeta eva. So he's established now that this kind of an adhikari is are there. The purva pakshi is sadly mistaken that there are no jijnyasus for this grantha. There are nobody who will engage. There are no adhikaris first, and then even adhikaris are there, they won't engage in this grantha. He is sadly mistaken. They will, then at least one will be there, and there will be many. In fact, most of the people who becomes mumukshus will finally become jijnyasus once they understand through satsanga that karma yoga, sankhya yoga, upasana itself may not give moksha. He will become a viveki so mature that he will know jnanam vina atyantika dukkha nivrutti hi aparokshatma jnanam vina atyantika dukkha nivrutti and nitya nirdishaya paramananda prapti will not be possible. That will be possible definitely. This viveka will be possible through karma yoga. Sankhya yoga upasanadi bhi, it will be possible definitely. Sankhya yoga will be jnana yoga as per Gita. Here karma yoga, sankhya and yoga can be separated, and upasana adi padena, everything you can add, any darshana you can add. Through those, the moksha, which is ananda rupa nitya and atyantika dukkha nivritti rupa, that kind of moksha cannot be attained through any of these. That is the viveka for this mukshu. Then this mukshu becomes a jijnyasu, and yasya satsanga jayate saha jijnyasu tasya jijnyasu ho advaita vedanta granthe asmin pravritti jayate eva. He has established that. So there is an adhikari. So this grantha also caters to those who are manda madhyama adhikaris, jijnyasus. Thereby the adhikari has been established, grantha prayojana has been established. Vishaya remains, Vishaya we'll look at in the next paatha. We'll peek into a little tippana in the next paatha and go to the Vishaya and Vishayakshepa Samadhana. Sukham Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namarupe Adhishtharam Buddhyam Buddhyabodhyam Buddher Drukyatthiram. Sorry, I'll... Sukham Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namaru Adhishtanam Buddhyabodhyam Buddher Drukyatthu Nirmalam Aparam Sarvedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadevahan Namattonya Kiti Menishitamatihi. Namaste. Any questions? We have time today. If there was anything from earlier or we have something today. Okay, namaste. I'll see you in the next part. Huh?
Hari Om.